What COVID-19 has taught us, our immediate response and long-term vision, by Charlene Lekay, Group CSI Manager. In 2017, the Momentum Metropolitan Foundation took the decision to recalibrate its strategic focus to that of youth empowerment. Integral to this was the formation of three key portfolios: Socioeconomic Development, SED, Consumer Financial Education, CFE, and the Staff Volunteer Program, SVP. We recognized that we needed a high level of expertise to drive our change in strategy. In order to achieve the impact we were striving for, we installed dedicated resources who would manage each portfolio, ensuring that we remained accountable to ourselves, our stakeholders, and our service users. The portfolio overviews offer a glimpse of the momentum gained over the past year, and one only needs to look at the growth we've seen in a short space of time to appreciate the importance of this investment. Shortly after the portfolios were initiated, we sought to establish a framework where we would track our progress, test our assumptions, and adjust our programs accordingly. This desire for formalization and structure led to the formation of our Monitoring, Evaluation and Compliance, MEC portfolio in 2018. As a result of this honed focus, we began to position ourselves as a collaborative partner to the public sector, as well as a hub of societal insight, which the broader business was able to draw from. In 2020, our best laid plans were disrupted by the arrival of COVID-19. As an NPC, we are attuned to the needs of society, both intuitively and by design. But this interruption was unprecedented, and the full breadth of the economic and social challenges became more apparent with each passing day. In response, the Foundation crafted a crisis proposal which saw the support of our NPO partner network prioritized and the interventions of the broader non-profit community augmented. The need for immediate aid was clear. And seemingly, overnight, our focus pivoted to one of relief. Three areas of vulnerability were highlighted: food security, healthcare, and physical safety, and social support, including education around the virus. A plan was devised that would buoy various community-focused interventions, and in the space of a weekend, it was resolved that 4.7 million rand in emergency funding would be made available to various service users. These included Riza Babuile, an NPO that services the Tembisa, Alexandra, Diepsloot, and Orange Farm communities. The funds were utilized to drive a community education campaign, as well as to ensure food security and supplement funding towards testing facilities. Ubuntu Pathways, an NPO located in Port Elizabeth. The funding assisted in disseminating information to Zwide Township residents on hygiene, physical distancing, and maintaining good health. We Think Code, a tech institution focused on skills development and software engineering. A stipend was provided to students who remained on campus in the first month of lockdown, covering their basic expenses. Other national and global organizations such as Red Cross and UNICEF, youth employment partners, and several NPOs forming part of For Goods Network. In a crisis, the need for a coherent plan is imperative, as is the speed of its execution. While good governance is critical, it often comes at the expense of expediency. With this in mind, one may question how the Foundation was able to secure funding approval in only a matter of days. This can be attributed to two factors: proper consideration and trust. Governance is beneficial to the planning process. It demands that all aspects be considered, forging a moment of calm reflection amidst the storm. In his message from the group CEO, Hilly Meyer highlights the importance of empowering people to do the right thing. It's vital to have this trust in your organizational structures so that when time is of the essence, Stakeholders are secure in knowing your processes are transparent and robust. The path ahead. As our chairman mentions in his introduction, while the foundation's strategic intent will remain fixed on youth empowerment, we've needed to re-envision how this looks in a COVID-19 world. We'll continue to build resilience into our structures, ensuring that we are flexible in our approach to supporting our partners and making a genuine impact in the communities that we serve. The organizations that will forge the road ahead in the new economy are those that are institutionally strong yet nimble, which demonstrate vigorous leadership, good governance, delivery, and integrity. We are proud that the foundation can be counted among these. We remain committed to our mandate of empowering youth and helping them achieve financial prosperity. While the path may change, we're confident that the destination will not.